Good evening, Twitch. How you doing? It's Thursday night. Hopefully you guys have been having yourselves a good week, and hopefully you're making yourself some plans for the weekend. For now, Heat 3 is now officially over, and I, for one, I now have to deal with a bunch of Octolings. So, unfortunately, I can't exactly play through the Octoling expansion. I know a lot of people have already blitzed through the entire expansion, but I currently don't have any plans to stream that yet or anything like that. I actually don't even know how much it costs right now. I'll be honest, I actually don't. But I thought I really haven't gotten much time to actually sit down and play any games. This week and this coming week are, like I said, you've seen my schedule. It's been very intermittent, having to make the events basically on the day. And just kind of take things one day at a time, and that's currently where I am, because things in real life are more important to deal with. But for tonight, though, we are going to be playing a little bit more Splatoon 2, but we're going to be playing the multiplayer. I've been trying to just kind of enjoy the multiplayer at my own pace. I've really finally gotten into playing the ranked mode. It's kind of nice, honestly. Let's see what stages we have here. I'm still not familiar with all of the maps. It's a place that exists. I haven't done League Battles yet, just because I don't really get to play this game with, other people. As you can see, I've been enjoying just... Basically, I've been leveling up all my armor. Or all my gear and such. I really haven't been earning much, much time to really play. And I really still haven't figured out how to actually increase the slots for clothes and such, because honestly, what I think would be pretty kind of cool. So far, I'm kind of addicted to the dually squelchers. I have seen a couple other squelchers. I would like to basically make outfits related for each weapon. It's honestly a pipe dream. It obviously require a lot of playtime, because I do like the splatter shot. The splatter shot, honestly, is actually pretty decent. I like the end zap's nice, but it's a Splattershot Junior. That's really what it is. But at the same time, I'm a sucker just for playing with the sapper, but I just like the range and the coverage you get from the dually squelchers, and Tenta missiles and sensors actually really good for a lot of the ranked modes. But I'm gonna finish leveling up the clothes here, and then we'll probably switch up and try and actually... I might actually scrub some gear, just so I can get more badges. I don't have any badges at all, actually, to actually customize clothes. Although I will say, the amount of stuff you can actually do... Was I in the wrong area? I was in the wrong area. The amount of stuff you can actually customize and stuff is actually pretty big. Let's see, was this the right area? No, what the heck is the area where... Where's the other area to check your badges? I could have sworn there was one. Might just be in the menu. No, that's the map. There it is, ability. Yeah, see, I have like four or five. I have six badges here, or ability chunks. And I think you need like 10 for all of them. And then there's a bunch of these here. No, I honestly wouldn't mind. See, I think I would like Respawn Punisher. I think I'm getting to that point where, I would like to get that as ability. Or Ability Doubler, if that's like... I've never seen Ability Doubler yet. I don't even understand why Object Shredder really exists. Hey, how's it going, Balthier? How's it going? Taking things one day at a time. That's honestly the best way to say it. Although I will say, like, I've really enjoyed E3. I've actually also been playing For Honor. I'm actually glad that's... The game has always been good. That's actually really nice. Come here, Goldie. That is very fresh. That is very well done. I always actually wonder how people can actually make art like that. There's some really good artists out there. And there's a fanfiction. 8-Ball. I don't understand why he doesn't like it. Yeah. Thank you very much for the 10 cents, Balthier. I had a feeling one person would actually do that. I don't know. Time and a place, honestly, for certain things. But yes, I finally just signed up for the affiliate. I'm slowly, very slowly, emphasis on very, going to be working on customizing everything. But I think one thing, I kept letting the perfect be the enemy of the good. And so I'm slowly working on, like, fleshing out a mission statement, what exactly what I want to do with the stream, what I want people to actually... If you're going to support me, what are they going to really gain? What am I going to gain in return? What are my goals? Because it's not like... Just simply give me money, and I'm going to buy this, or anything like that. I want to find a I want to give people a reason to support, you know, support me. And in return, they would actually get something that they could actually... That they would actually want, or could actually use. And that's the hardest part, is like, what happens when you really don't have anything to start with. And that's what I want to work towards. That's honestly my goal. Hello, world. Happy Pride Month. I actually do wonder how people make, like, this one obviously you can tell is hand-drawn, but we can get back to, that's a good statement, huh? Like this, like, I actually don't know how people actually make something like this. Like, that is really well done. Yeah, that's honestly my plan, is to take my time. Give your Octo friends a very warm welcome to Inkopolis. I'll give him a warm welcome with a perfect time splatting. Also, a lot of high-level players have been coming out. I mean, a lot of people. See, like that. That is insane. Also, this person has played this game way too much. Way better art than you could ever do? Well, maybe for the time. You never know. And, like, just honestly, you know, was it? I've been seeing one person from Proton John's Discord, Tails Fraga. They've been doing a great job. Constantly improving their craft. And that's the thing, honestly, that's another thing I want to do. I want to find a way to kind of improve everything to make it something people will want. 8-Ball. Okay, clearly this expansion is making everyone hate the 8-Ball. But enough talk. Let's actually get some matches here. It's a process, honestly, and that's honestly one of my desires. To get from this is spending more time, not simply streaming. Like, the schedule is pretty much, I'm happy with that. That's honestly the one thing I've been trying to just simply work on, is making sure I can do I can do the streams I say I do. So it's like, I have 2 hours, I'm going to give you 2 hour streams of content. Will the content change? It probably will. But once again, that's kind of an overtime thing. You've seen a few matches of John play this game, but I don't know much about it. Wow, that's actually a surprise. That's one of the few times that's actually happened. Well, do you have any questions or anything like that? I'd be happy to answer. I mean, if anything, at its fundamental, it is still a third-person shooter. But the difference is they added a layer, at least in terms of regular battle. Like, this is a control, like tower control. So this is kind of adding a third layer. There's a clear objective, there's a way for winning and losing in this match, which is basically... So we're here on tower control, I've got the Amari Towers. This is actually going to be the stage you're going to see in Smash Brothers. But it's just teams of 4v4, and for this mode you just try to take care of the tower. But what makes this interesting, I'm actually not going to be engaging on this immediately. You're basically working towards spreading your ink around, like I am, which lets you not only hinder the movement of your allies, but also hinders the movement of enemies, but also give your characters a place where they can actually reload. Because reloading in this game is actually done by... you can either stop firing, that's one way to actually reload. Or you could duck into hold ZR. I'm just gonna call it R2. Let's be honest. I'm sorry. There's one thing PlayStation has really shown me. It's that where the heck are they? And so we have this enemy ink here. If I actually walk over the enemy ink, my movement is actually hindered. For the regular mode, it is that. Like, you really didn't see me do much of anything in terms of direct conflict. So what my strategy is when I play this is actually to work on getting my super up. Because the one thing the custom dualies are really good at, and I'll actually show it in a second here, I'll actually leave this match and just do a regular turf war to kind of show things. Yeah, so I was basically giving assists by constantly spamming my special. I'll actually go to Nope here, just for a second. So, let me go to Equipment. And I can actually just go to my weapons here. So, each weapon basically has a certain amount of range, they do a certain amount of damage, and they also have... basically like a trietary stat. Usually it's like they'll show fire rate or mobility, like how fast you'll actually be moving while you're shooting, or how far away is your dodge roll. Like the dualies have a dodge roll mechanic, so the splatter shot will just show like a fire rate instead. And of course you always have a sub, which is R1, and then you have your Tenta missile, your special, which for this one's the Tenta missiles. You basically press in R3, so you press in the joystick. But what you see there at the very bottom of turf inked and points for special basically shows you how much land you've actually covered with ink. Now it could be land that hasn't been inked at all by yourself, or land that's been inked by your enemies. And so the moment you reach that certain point value, you get your special. And that's where you can press R3. And launch your Tenta missiles, or for the splatter shot here, you get the inkjet. As you can see, it costs 30 more points just to actually launch that, or to actually use your special. The subs, like I said, it just costs from ink from your main tank. And I'll use that quite a bit. I think I use the splatter shot. Yeah, I use the splatter shot junior for quite a bit, actually. I haven't really played a lot with a lot of the other guns. There's a lot of them. Like, the Undercover Umbrella here has Splashdown, but you can see it doesn't cost that much to get your special up. And the great thing about using your specials in this game is that it'll... Even if you're an empty tank of ink for your ammo, the moment you use your special, you are back to full. So that's actually one reason why I've been liking the dually squelchers, is because I can go through ink really, really quickly, but then I can actually use my special and get it all back. And that's my current strategy in terms of playing. And there's a couple others that aren't really as friendly. Like I said, was it the splash shot here takes 210? That's actually quite a bit. The splash shot, just the normal one, just takes 200. That's it. Usually around that much there. I actually don't have many of the weapons unlocked. I kind of been focused on getting the weapons and clothes I actually want. But you also have ability, your clothes here basically kind of show your enhancements and such. And you can actually just press L2 just to see what they are. So like this reduces the special gauge decrease after getting splatted. So if you get splatted, you're gonna lose your you're gonna lose part of your special. Not all of it, but part of it. But then you also have subcategories, or I guess minor improvements, which are the badges under, which are the abilities underneath there. And those are like micro level improvements. So the big ones have a more significant effect than the small ones. So they're not equal. So there's the sub abilities, which, you know, make minor improvements, but then the ones, the clothes that actually have it. So it's like, you just notice only the first ones are highlighted. Those have a much bigger improvement, like special charge up. Combine that with the dually sculptures and you can launch Tenta missiles very, very quickly. But that's an example of all the clothes. But let's just do a regular battle here. So regular battle is just turf war. And that's just basically saying killing the opponent, the enemy team, doesn't actually mean victory. What it actually means, it buys you more time to cover the battlefield in ink. And that's what Turf War really is about. So as it says here, ink the most turf to win. I've never actually really played this map before. And there are a lot of people who like the sculptures, I've noticed. So basically any land, so you can ink the walls and such, and you can even use that to your advantage and climb the walls, but the goal is to just claim as much turf as possible. So like you see I'm out of ink, but I can hold L2 and go into cover. And when it says every single bit of turf, anything that's considered ground, that's actually not ground. So you can see there's a lot of... I've actually been discovered. It's a little hard to build up your special, honestly, like, compared to ranked mode. Like, I can actually just ink up, gain ammo, and climb, and also just die. Because I did not see him. So like I said, it's really focused. I'm gonna even press X there, just take a look at the map. See what hasn't been covered, what has. And so you can actually go through a lot of matches without actually really fighting a lot of people, if you so choose to. But you kind of want to try and at least get some sort of kills. Because they're going to be launching their specials as well. Because you're all competing just to cover the most ground. And you basically will slowly, like, you can end up working your way towards the enemy's base! green's behind? Yes, we're definitely behind. We are most certainly behind right now. Like, Turf War is a whole nother beast. It really is a whole nother beast. Yeah, so, like, there's someone who's just using their special and just spam. It's honestly a spam. I'm really bad. Thank you! That was a really good support. And there's Tenta missiles. What?! Oh, there's a person who's played this game way too much. There's a lot of people who's played this game a lot. Like, that's honestly an understatement. And it makes sense, honestly. This is actually really fun first-person shooter. I think my one complaint, and this is honestly a personal one because I acknowledge I'm not great at this. I'm really not great at this game. Like, I think I like the ranked mode better? Oh, I think we won just sim- No, wait. Yeah, we won. So, I can actually bring the map here. You could see in the upper right section there, there's actually a lot of turf they didn't ink on their side, which is why we won. If they actually inked all of that, that gray area there in the upper right, they would have won. Easy. And that's the thing that makes the normal mode very interesting. Because it only counts ground that has been inked. So other than that though, it's very straightforward. It just basically de-emphasizes getting kills. Like, you play any other third-person shooter and stuff. Like Space Marine. Space Marine 40K. I loved that, that third-person shooter game. And foolishly, and I'll say this is foolishly, I learned how to play that game with a gamepad. Reason why I played that on PC, it had a great multiplayer. It was amazing. It was, if anything, probably one of the best multiplayer experiences I had for a third-person shooter game. The downside is, though, and I would still recommend the game, so, like, single-player is still actually really fun. It is amazing. It is a, you know, if you enjoyed games like Halo and all that stuff, or just like the Warhammer 40k universe and such, it's a lot of fun. Like, you are basically the one, you are literally a one-man army. And it also had a very interesting story mode as well. It actually was planned to be a trilogy, but it got cut short. But the great thing about, well, the reason why I was terrible at, Space Marine, though, even though I leveled got the max level and stuff in the game, was, if you played with a keyboard and mouse, obviously you're more accurate in your shooting and stuff. I used a gamepad, which made me terrible. So it's important, though, with all this turf here, to actually take a moment and actually ground it, which is kind of like what I do, because a lot of people just like going in the battle. And I don't blame them, because that's, honestly, if you're really good at it, that's kind of what you want to do. Or if you're kind of a scrub like me right now. Kind of best to kind of sit back and try and just cover as much ground as you can. When I say every little bit of ground, everything that you can walk on. If it has any sort of verticality... There's a person. Throw the fire on YouTube. Enjoy some missiles. Like, we're in danger, they're clearly having more, has more stuff inked. Ooh. Ah, darn it. I don't get to play many online games, either, or if I do, it's kind of, it's more of, you know, I'm a lone wolf. I'm a lone wolf player. It's actually a lot of turf I've not touched at all. Like I said, no, like, even though, like, we're probably losing a lot. I wouldn't be surprised. Yeah, it's 3v1. We're actually down a player. Though someone didn't connect to the match. So it's very unlikely we're actually going to win. Just because we're just down a person. I noticed that actually happens the most in, multiplayer. See you later, Octoling. I heard the Last of Us multiplayer was actually pretty good. I heard it was pretty good. Yeah, it looks like two people are... Are we actually... Yeah, actually, it's only two people. Oh, that's unfortunate. Hi there. I'd like to get a kill, please. Yeah, when there's two people, kind of makes sense. See, I don't buy into that, honestly. The whole... I don't like to believe... It only... Like, okay, let me make some assertions here. If you're in voiceover IP, and the person obviously is being a jerk, then yeah, you call him a jerk. Don't call him toxic. They're just being a jerk, and that's all they're doing. And they might just be doing it. They might not actually forget, you know, you'd be surprised, honestly, some people who just take their outlet and just be a jerk. Now, there's a difference between a person saying, and let's put this into context here, doing some trash talking or just saying, it's like, man, you're doing terrible right now, and that can be a legitimate criticism. But then it's important to divide that. Yeah, see, we had two people who just weren't even there. That's actually what happened. But it's important to make the distinction of the people who say, like, you know, that criticize you, even if they do it poorly, like saying, man, you're doing terrible, compared to saying, something I've been having to deal with a lot lately. You know, people who just go off and say, like, you know, go off and, you know, it's the terrible things you actually hear. So, like, go, you know, go kill yourself. And like I said, I'm not telling people anyone to do this. I'm putting this in context. The context is, it's important to divide people who give criticism towards your gameplay or make statements of how you're performing. I think that's fine. Everyone has their bad times playing games, but then they're taking it a step too far, and they're either being, you know, they're honestly just being complete. I'm trying to think what the best word he actually uses here. Because, like I said, it's all too easy. If you lump everyone in together and just use a buzzword like toxic, it doesn't actually help anyone. And very often you end up damning people who honestly just might be having an off day or having not having a good time in their real life. Again, I feel like it's very important to make those distinctions. That's just a personal thing. So I don't like saying it's like, because there's always time to reform or give people an actual honest second chance. I mean, I will say, though, if a person's being annoying, that's, on a personal level, I can't tolerate it myself, but hey, you know what, you work on it. You know, everyone has to tolerate at least some level of behavior, and it could be something like, it honestly could just be someone's natural voice. That's, you know, let's not say that's a bad thing either. That was actually a bad thing. Let's get that up. But I'd honestly say, you know, like, this multiplayer is actually really good. Like, there definitely is an active community. You don't have to actually you don't need to socialize with anyone if you don't want to. Oh, that's actually plastic wrapped. Hello, I see you. They kind of doomed themselves on that one. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with being the quiet type. Oh good, that was blue. I thought that was ours. Actually start using the sensor here. So like I said, you can go like two-thirds of the match just not literally running into anyone. Just because you take the time to actually ink the ground that's yours. And it's very important you actually do that. Obviously something like a roller would probably be a better tool or a more efficient tool to actually do all of this, but you work with what you got. Like, I could just, like, I say if you're interested in, you know, fighting people and such. That person is really good with that splatterola. Well, the one thing I can say, if you have trouble expressing yourself, it's important to practice. Ah, darn it. It's honestly important to practice. Don't think we're gonna win this one, though. Unless we turn it around at last second here. Ah, right. The roller's good. Like, it can be really, really good. I'm terrible with it. to be quite frank. I'm absolutely terrible with it. I think they won. Yeah, they won. The biggest thing is you really had to learn how to aim the roller. Oh, we didn't even have... Wait. That... What? I'm sorry, I was a bit confused, because one of our players didn't have anything, and yet they had two kills and one special. That's a bit confusing. I mean, I could... Do you want me to show you some of the other weapons, Balthier? I will tell you right now, I'm terrible. But that's actually the good thing about the normal mode. It's just Turf War. There's no other game modes or anything like that. And... the primary objective isn't kills. It rewards people to be more strategic as they play. And I actually appreciate that sort of thing. Like, obviously, if you can get kills, it will, you know, give them less time. So there is an importance in making that distinction. Like, you're basically decreasing the amount of time they can actually turf the arena and such. That's fine, use weapons. Yeah, this is the... I'm gonna stick using these then. I will say Masayanella's advice is probably the best. If you... What I could do, what I need to do... Alright, these missiles are taking... How long are these missiles gonna take here? Okay. That was taking way too long for those missiles. That was a waste of my time. There we go. Let's take out these two. And inking is just to go up onto the walls and such. You don't actually need to, going on here? There's someone there. Yep, there is. Oop! Nope, nope, nope. I know what you... I just walked into a zinc storm. But you'll see, like, some of the really good players have very specialized builds and such. And just remember, only the ground counts, nothing else. I can actually get up here and just start inking everywhere. Ah, come on. Nice. Oop! I ran out of ink. That's honestly my weakness, honestly, with me and the, when I play Turf War, I'm terrible at ammo management. Because I just... I still very much... Like I said, I'm very much a newbie. Like, someone like Massey probably would just destroy me in this game. Oh, hello. And a lot of veterans came back for the Octo expansion. A lot of veterans. Like, I think these are honestly the highest level players I've seen for this game. Ah, come on, really? Okay, good. Woo! Rollers are everywhere! But like I said, I gained a better appreciation of ranked mode than Turf War. Like, Turf War, I'm terrible at. I'm absolutely terrible at it. Because either... It's one of those things that always happens. And it always happens with no matter what multiplayer game you have. You either have teammates who focus purely on the enemy. Or... And this is the other factor. Actually... I need to actually change my gear. They either focus on just the enemy, and they never turf anything. Or they're just so focused on getting a kill count. Like, it's what, you know, it's honestly, it's like the standard It's a standard tropes of running into other players. Actually, like, no. Oh, okay, good. I can actually level up these. My biggest downside right now, I haven't found many clothes I actually like. Because I'll be honest, I would love to just have, like, a sell option. I would like to have a sell option, because a lot of these clothes here I just bought just because I thought, okay, you know, let's just get this gear. Because I thought, like, oh, either it'd be better or it had another slot, and then I slowly learned, nope, you just get them because... What does this have? Last ditch effort? That's actually not bad. But more, things you can actually level up, the better. But the reason why I liked ranked mode, it's that... As fun as Turf War is, and Turf War is actually awesome, I'd say that's probably your best casual mode. I like ranked battle better... Because it's so focused on a single objective. And it's where... Even though it does put more emphasis on getting kills... You still have that secondary objective, which is more important than worrying about getting kills. I still haven't tried League, but from what I understand, League and Ranked are basically the same. The only difference is play with a team of friends that you have. But you could tell I don't really actually have a, I don't have, like, any of the builds I want or anything like that. And you could basically see the other reason why I kind of like the ranked mode better. It's a lot easier because people don't spend their time, I could have gotten that third one, inking the turfs, and there's a lot of gray area you could basically just use just to get a couple of early missiles and such, which is actually a lot more important than you'd think. Bombs away! Because, like, a lot of people just simply rush to the point. What? Oh no! That was a really good missile launcher. It's a shame. I lost to the guy with custom dualies. So, if anything... Let's actually... There we go! Oh no! Terrible at aiming. Actually, just take that. And it's really cool, like, even with all the, like, you're always constantly... Thank you! Take care of that. Like, you're constantly just inking and getting your specials and stuff, and this is what makes it a little more, like, a fun, chaotic... I actually know I'm here. And I have no ammo. Lovely. Ah! So when you get into the thick of it, like, it can be fun, but you can see how much special I actually lost from dying that time. There we go. So, like, you can still support your team even if you're not directly fighting. You don't want to avoid fighting completely, though. Like, if you avoid fighting completely, you're obviously going to suffer, because you're not offering your support to your team. But I think right now everything's in kind of disarray, because there's a lot of people, a lot of veterans, that are coming back to this game. I can see, like, each of my teammates, 3-1-1 special, so they use their specials, like, a couple of times. I used mine 5 times. Kind of a big difference. And plus, if you are looking to get money, I think ranked is better. At least if you win. If you lose horribly in ranked, you do not get any money at all. If you lose horribly, which has happened multiple times as I've played this game. I mean, absolute annihilation. I think there's one mode I still have not ranked up in for the ranked mode. And there's also a constant map rotation and game mode rotation for ranked, which also makes it really nice. I think this is honestly a solid... There's definitely people who just keep playing this game. It's honestly a solid bunch of people who keep playing it. And I think right now there's actually a lot of people from Proton John's Discord who are actually streaming this game right now. I think Juker's streaming it right now. He does his multiplayer game nights. So he actually plays with friends. And I think he also plays with viewers as well. So there's a lot of people who are currently active playing this game right now. And for good reason. Like, personally, I still would like to go and get, buy, Senran Kagura Peach Peach Splash and like to try that game out. Oh, come on, I love that. That's honestly one of my favorites. If I could... darn. VMO too good. Oh, they already got past the checkpoint. Alright. That makes sense. I am going to die. I'm going to die. Damn, Inkstorm. Inkstorm normally doesn't kill me, that's the interesting part. This is the second time it's actually- I think it's like the fourth time an Inkstorm has actually killed me. They're actually still improving. Nope! Someone had to draw him out. Unfortunately, that's a terrible place. These players are actually really, really good. Absurdly good. No! Please no. Nah, they want it. Thank you very much, Exposure. Thank you very much, Savior, for the host. Yeah, that's another thing I want to do is change the alerts and stuff. I have nothing against Wayne June. Wayne June is still an awesome, awesome voice actor and voice performer. From Darkest Dungeon, and he even did the PC game show again, actually. I believe this is the second time, actually, doing the PC game show as the... not the host, but the announcer. No, the color contrast is always good. They're, like, they clearly show that they understand the color wheel. I don't think they're choosing the... it's not exact, it's not precise, like, them choosing the polar opposite colors. But they're choosing... the colors that do have a contrast. No, it's not going to be like red versus blue, I think, was it? It's blue and orange. Blue and orange. I'm trying to remember some of the other colors. I'm trying to remember what color combinations they actually use, because it's not... they don't really just assign you a color at random. Good for people with... I am colorblind. And, yeah, so green and... yeah, so we have green and blue here. Wait, is that green and blue? Is that blue? I'm actually colorblind. So, when most people say they're colorblind, they're usually they're partially colorblind. They're not full-on... like, they're... if you actually meet an actual person who is full-on colorblind, I would be shocked. To be quite frank. Please don't splat me! I have so many Tenta missiles I need to fire. Now you do actually have to stand on the tower to actually get credit. If you actually want credit, you gotta stand on the tower. So you do need a sacrificial lamb. Oop, shoot. Ah, I'm terrible at this. This is why you don't have me to actually do this. Oh no. One. You smart little devil, you. Ah, I'm terrible at this. Like I said, this is why I don't like being on the tower. It basically is the universal sign of shoot me, shoot me. Also, no, actually can't. Or I'm going to super jump. Alright, fine. That's a wonderful decision. So you can actually also super jump in this game. What that basically means is you teleport towards one of your players. It's a little confusing to read, honestly. Cause it's one of those things where to actually this is not good. There we go. Just know where they are. There we go. I prefer being the support. That's my preference. Is everyone? Alright, I have to fire it. The moment you activate your spec. Good job, Kirby. The moment you activate your special, if you don't use it, it'll slowly lose its charge, and if you don't fire it, you lose it completely. No idea what I'm aiming at here. Know what I'm aiming at now. Hopefully this will actually show where everyone is. I actually like the point sensor. It's not really for killing. It just reveals where the enemies are. And I think also, like, you will gain... I think in rank mode as well, you gain special as well. There's like a passive mechanic for gaining special. Whatever. And the winners is just by distance, so probably not gonna win this one. Just because we're constantly losing, and I really should be using the super jump more. I am terrible at this game. The one big thing I actually have a problem with at start that made me really bad was actually the speed in which you aim. And that's honestly any good person who's good at third person or first person shooters will have just instant reflexes. Yeah, so unfortunately we lost this, I think. I don't think we can go into overtime. Never mind, no, I don't think we can. So, if you're in overtime, you have to stand on the tower. If we can... Nope. Darn. There is an overtime mechanic. If you basically have possession of the ball or the tower, then it'll go into overtime. But the moment you lose control of it, it'll be game over. A lot of people using the squelchers. I think for if you're just playing normal mode, turf mode, you're probably getting about 1,000 experience, 1,000 gold a match, Ranked, you can probably gain like 2,000 if you actually win. So there's a huge difference, but you can also lose a lot. Like, I think we got 800 experience, 800 gold for that match. But you can actually, if you do so terrible, you could literally get zero. But it's like, there's actually a lot of really good multiplayer games out there that have been surviving. I mean, Rainbow Six Siege is a solid one. That's a really good tactical shooter game. For Honor, now that they actually fixed all the connectivity issues, it looked like a close match. I still consider myself not that great at this game, honestly. Like, there are a lot of people who are just either... And it's just more of a personal... It's a skill thing. Like, the one thing I know I'm terrible at when it comes to third-person, first-person shooters is aiming. And this kind of applies to, like, games like Realm Royale as well. Like, that's honestly why I don't do a lot of, shooter games, is because, well, I just know that's my weakness, my personal weakness. Ooh! Ah, darn it. Let me guess. Yeah, he's doing dually spell just too. But it just comes to like, mouse acceleration or the aiming speed and such. Like, that's where I really suffer. Like, dollars for donuts, the you know, when it comes to actually trying to figure out that one little moment of how to actually aim properly, that is where I suffer. One. Like, the downside about the, my guns, the custom squelchers, is that they're very low damage, but they're a very high range. So if I ever get into the, close range, I'm going to lose against those enemies, against that, you know, those players. Hang on. Stay away from me! Even though that only takes one. See, that player was smart. He actually used a super jump to actually, get back to the, get back to his allies. So super jump actually is really useful, like... Probably not gonna super jump there, because that person who just super jumped is probably gonna die instantly. Because the downside about super jump is, if you don't use it right, you're going to... It's a fast travel mechanic, and it's really good as a fast travel mechanic. The downside is, though... I'm out of ink again. Keep doing that. I'm dead. Flooded by another person to use the missiles 1 second ahead of me. Yeah, so we're in the lead right now. Now I have to understand why Object Shredder exists. Who the heck is with that Splatbrella? Yeah, that's honestly where I've always suffered, is up. Oh, they are gonna take the lead. They took the lead. Like, I still haven't figured out, like, how is that person's... Now that's impressive. That person knows how to roll. I have no ink. I am inkless. Like I said, I like playing a support. Because if you play a support, well, everyone will super jump to you. And you can keep the pressure on. Oh my god, how many times can this person dodge roll? No! I have no ink! I deserve that. I deserve that. But I think we should have this. They're gonna get overtime. Because if they take over the tower, they're gonna get overtime. What I'm gonna do... launch all my missiles. Here on the high ground. Take care of you. And make them all leave the tower. Because they're all standing on it. That was a really close match. But yeah, when it comes to aiming speed, like Realm Royale, PUBG, Splatoon 2, even Space Marine, all of them, I always have trouble aiming. Like, it's basically, you know, for something like Warhammer and such, it's like, it's the difference between getting... Oh, maps have changed. It's the difference between getting a headshot and a body shot. And usually what will happen, I'll get a body shot. Oh, and here's one of the modes I'm not that fond of. Clam Blitz. This is effectively like taking down the enemy base. But you do it by finding clams and turning them into footballs. I am serious, you literally turn them into footballs. And use the football to destroy the barrier, to throw any additional clams you have inside. You have to give them food. You probably won't see me do it. Can I just ink this and... yeah, so we also... basically our bases have 100 health, we just have to bring ours down to 0. The little interesting thing about this, you really have to learn how to actually bring up the minimap multiple times, and I think that's honestly where the, so this is actually our base here. So if the enemy throws a football at it, our base will burst, and then they can actually throw footballs, or throw clams inside of it. So we already broke their barrier, so someone threw a football in there. Aww. I'm gonna make it my goal. I'm gonna make my goal not to die. My other goal is to be in a position... so there's a blue mark there, that means someone has a football. And that means they can actually destroy a base. But if I press X, if they're actually spawning... or Octoling. Like, they're very hard, they're little blips. You can actually find out where the dots are and such. Oh crap. Yeah, see, these are the clams. Yeah, I should grab these four here! That person was greedy. He's raining clams! So I have 6 clams right now, so if I get a couple more... or if the base gets destroyed, like it's vulnerable right now, I should have actually done that. Oh, crap! Oh! Alright, please, for the love of God, help me. I actually have no... no, I still have my football. Run away! Oh, I walked into it. Oh, and my football fell off the map. That's the hard part. I always have trouble, actually finding the right moment to actually go on the offensive. That's why I try and play more support. That's my benefit. Because I am a person who enjoys playing tactically. Plus, the other thing is everyone just goes for clams, then it kinda creates a problem. Oh, there. Here, someone take this. See, so now... Yep. Okay, those three people knew how to play this game a little too well. He literally annihilated the others. Like, I think if you have a good anchor, and it would make sense if I was actually good with a sniper to be in the back constantly. But I'm not. But I don't mind spamming my special any chance I can get. I just realized this actually wasn't the game mode I'm the worst at. There's still one I've never done. But I think I like ranked more, because you get more rewards, or you have the opportunity to get more rewards, and it encourages taking out your enemy just a little bit more while working towards the objective instead of turfing all the aim. Because I'll be honest, when I play Turf War, majority of the match I'm not even in conflict with anyone, and I want at least a certain level of conflict. Like, Turf War is still a very solid mode, I highly recommend it. Because it's, you know, this game is not just about getting kills. And I think that's the best part. See anything you wanted in E3? Honestly, I thought this year of E3 was really, really strong. Like, a lot of people are being either overly harsh or really cynical. Like, no offense, like, ProJared does a solid job at being an entertainer and covering and talking about games he cares about. But I think he's a little overly harsh, or a little overly cynical. But then again, it's like, that's what happens when you try and grade conferences. There's nothing good can come from it when you have to, when you make it like, I'm grading E3. But it's probably what gets views. I'm not cynical enough. Oh, that's beautiful. I am not cynical enough. To be the person to say it's like, oh, they're just doing it for money and stuff. Like, I understand, thanks to, Right, I'm not green. I don't know why I thought that was my eye. But as for what I wanted from E3, Daemon X Machina. So the reason for that... Oh, please don't glitch out on me, controller. So the reason for that game, I'd like to know more about that game, is because... the people who developed it, and this is actually the theme I want to redesign my streams and stuff around, at least in terms of an art aesthetic. No idea where the enemy is, and that's actually a bad thing. There's an enemy here, isn't there? There was, at least. How the heck is he that fast? Oh, it doesn't matter, we broke the barrier, at least. What? Alright, Bright's actually really good. So, Daemon X Machina, Smash, obviously. Not even because I didn't even get to own a Wii U, so I didn't get to enjoy playing Smash with a lot of people. The last Smash game I owned was Brawl. There's someone with a basketball. Oh, with a football. You can't pick up the enemy team's football. Just to let you know. You're not gonna get a lot of luck on that. And there is also a... Got it! I got lucky there. I didn't even realize I had a football for a while. I'm actually surprised I was able to pull that off. So that's what you're supposed to do. Like I said, the downside is I'm terrible at aiming, and to throw the clams, you actually had to press A. Oh, hello. He is, that person's really good. I have played some Smash, which I love. See, I like Smash, at least for the, if you're playing casually, because I'm not gonna denigrate the hardcore here, but at the same time, oh good, we all died. They have taken it to an absurd level. Oh, they are wrecking our barrier. They just took the lead with that play. That was a solid play. So when the barrier's back up, it requires an actual football. Come on! And I'm out of eight. But, I'm terrible at fighting games, too. I really am. Like, because the one downside of when online play past Battle.net from the original days of Dota, happened. Good job. You got it. And someone needs to pick this up, because if you don't pick up the football, it will go away. Smiley face there. Like, I'm conflicted with Dead or Alive. Dead or Alive 6. It's coming out. That's a overall positive. Wow, I did not expect the Ink Rush to actually go over the edge like that. Yeah, so we're one away. Yep. Oh, we've taken the lead. We actually won. I'm actually surprised this game mode had an overtime. I never saw that before. I was winning by 1 point. Dead or Alive 6. I'm conflicted, just simply because the downside of Dead or Alive 6 is that it's in new hands. It's not in Itagaki's hands anymore. He's long left. Dead or Alive, and it's honestly kind of the reason why it's always kind of been at a downward spiral. And like Dead or Alive 1, that was a great way to introduce a melee focused counter/counter grab system. I really like that. The move set for each of the characters were expansive but yet small enough, and they did the same thing with Dead or Alive 2. Both of those games were really, really great. Never got to play Dead or Alive 3 or 4, because that's when it went Xbox exclusive. I was able to enjoy Dead or Alive 5, but that's where I noticed, and we're talking decades difference here between Dead or Alive 2 and Dead or Alive 5. They homogenized the move sets, and they made a lot more moves in terms of the counter grabbing and such to be a lot more complex. And a little, like, honestly too complex for me. And that's where I have no idea where I'm fighting here, because I'm actually not familiar with this map. This is our barrier. Okay. And that is all rubber. Okay. There's someone over there. That person has a thingy. I'm gonna die here. Thank goodness the other person saved me. He saved my life. I can be as bad as I want to be. And not in the good way. Yeah, see, so there's some clams. The barrier's up, we can actually all throw clams. There's four clams there. But So they homogenized the movesets, which made characters like Jan Li even more difficult to actually play. Oh, hello. Person. Yeah, there's an Inkling. Go kill it. Go kill that Inkling. Or Octoling. Or whoever it is, actually. I have no ammo. Nope, he's gonna get it. GR Sceptile is actually really good. Good job, man. You can see how much ink it drains just to actually take from your secondary. But I'm conflicted because the new head in charge of the Dead or Alive franchise is clearly going for a hardcore fighting demographic in esports, and in turn, they've also gone on this campaign of reducing sexuality. And that to me has been... I'm gonna die here. I'm dead. It's reducing sexuality, and from what I understand from the, that's the problem, is basically when people hear Dead or Alive, and I don't want, like, either they're honestly shallow people, or, and I want to be very specific on this, or they don't know enough about the franchise that they're willing to throw they throw basically the entire thing under the bus. I live alive! I'm taking those. Also taking those plants. Or not, because that person killed me. But people aren't familiar with... If you have a shallow knowledge of Dead or Alive, what it basically comes down to is... I like boobies. Like, it's bouncing breasts. That's what the... You know, they don't study the characters, they don't understand their backstory, or their interconnections with the main plot, or anything... Anything in depth about it. I'm trying, actually. Uh-oh. Well, at least we killed each other. Because the one thing that's existed since the start of Dead or Alive was the bouncing breasts mechanic. And that's been something you've always been able... And this is actually probably the most important thing to note. You've always actually been able to turn it off. Bouncing breasts in the Dead or Alive series, because each of the characters were designed, and they're expert fighters, you know, there's ninjas, there's pro wrestlers, there's students who, you know, studying fighting and aspiring to become a great fighter, people learning traditionally from, like, their masters. There's a wide background of characters, you know, as expertise in their martial arts. But the problem is, all of that is in depth. You have to actually go and understand the characters and their connection to other characters, like Jan Li and Lei Fang have this connection to each other, because she, you know, Lei Fang admires Jan Li, but Jan Li has this incredible drive of being the best fighter, not just, you know, being the best fighter basically in the world, and he wants to recognize it, which is why he, you know, gets involved in the Dead or Alive tournaments. He's not actually interested in anything else. But you'll never hear a person who, you know, talks about Dead or Alive past, hey, those girls have big breasts. You know, you never hear a person, like, saying, like, making a connection with Tina, because Tina's... was basically a playoff with her father, because she wasn't just like your rebellious character, she had a lot of, you know, personal aspiration towards a lot of careers and stuff. Like, she was a wrestler, she wanted to be a model, and she's constantly aspiring to do new things. Something very, you know, something that honestly to be admired. But you don't get that. I just killed myself here, aren't I? I'm killing myself. Mm-hmm. Alright, I'm just gonna run away. And then I am going to launch the missiles. And I'm going to run away like a coward. Gonna do this for a second. No. It's very hard to actually get the football in, because there usually can be someone who is playing heavy defense. Sorry, I have to concentrate now because these guys are actually... this combination's actually really good. So... really like... There we go, that's how you do it. That is how you do it. Now I'm going to die. I'm going to die a horrible... the clams. Taking the clams. Oh crap. I regret nothing! Alright, you can have your ground back. Uh oh, someone has a football. So when you have a football, when they have a football, they basically can't... there we go, finally happened. It can be very easy to turn it on, have the match turn on you. So, back to Dead or Alive. So the reason why Dead or Alive, I'm not liking the direction it's taking. See, like, these guys know what they're doing, and I have no aim. I just killed myself again. So this is actually a very good chance, if they have a football, to just annihilate us. I don't think they have a football, though. No, they don't have a football. But they did ink our entire ground. No! No hiding! Alright, nope. He knows. He knows! He knows! That was... actually, no! That was actually a good rain. is that ours? No, that's theirs. I also didn't know this mode actually would spawn a football if you broke the barrier. That seems like you could... okay, alright, I'm good. No, you don't. Oop! Like I said, you could easily turn this match around in seconds if you're good. That person really wants to score. He actually might. We need to kill him. Hoop! Damn hamster ball. We actually have to kill the guys with footballs, or else I think it will. Nope, they won. There's a good chance they'll actually win. They pulled it out. They did a good job. Like I said, it's very easy for this match to turn ourselves. But back to Dead or Alive 6. So, well, people who actually... this isn't even like a whole like true fan thing. It's people who actually take an interest in the franchise. And they might think the plot's, you know, the overarching plot's silly or the characters are silly, and that's fine. You can criticize it however you want, but you, there's a difference between, like, actually knowing the game and the characters and the story and their interconnections and not knowing it and just looking at it from a shallow perspective and saying, this game is sexist because all the female characters have big breasts or are models. Which is why, like, Dead or Alive 3 Extreme Beach Volleyball, I was upset because that game was going to be ported to the PC, it was going to be released in the United States, but then you have these ideologues getting everyone so upset, this vocal minority of people, getting people upset, saying, you know, how degrading that game is. The developers didn't even want to release it stateside. And the only way for you to play it is if you own a PS4 and you buy the international version, which does have English subtitles and such. I don't think it has English voice acting, which is okay. Like, I'll be honest, I'm actually okay with dubs. Like, I know dubs get a lot of crap, but I actually am probably one of the few people who say, it's like, no, I'm okay. Like, I want actors to act, I want models to model, and I want people to actually have a career, you know, have the career they actually want. Like, I think, you know, what is it, Tina from Dead or Alive, I think she's honestly a really good role model for a lot of men and women out there. I see what you did there. You could have had that kill. That person could have had that kill very easily. Also, here, give me those clams. I'm actually not doing my job, I should be throwing out the sensor. But, like I said, you get that huge difference. I have no ink. This is either brilliant or dumb. No, it's clear. Yeah, so 10 clams makes a football. And I just back rolled into the enemy. IR special. But because there's such a lot of people who basically only know Dead or Alive as it's the game with females, women with big breasts, they basically don't, either they don't take it seriously or they just view it as, oh, this is a game for people to rank off to. And I could... Damn, thought I would get away. And I only, like, I understand the fundamental part of it, but at the same time, I disagree with it heavily because there are so many ways... I already... running out of ink. Oh, he had a roller. That would explain. It's like, how'd I get one shot? He had a roller. Sorry, it's hard for me to discern my thoughts and focus on this at the same time. Because it requires a lot of explanation, and you really have to... Why do I keep firing when I know I'm out of ink? It's hard to honestly make a counter-argument when you're actually playing a game. Let's just be straight about that. That's the problem. And it also doesn't help my controller's going haywire. Like, I'm holding forward right now and my character's walking backwards. I'm dead. I just walked into that. I'm doing terrible this round. Like, we have not been able to make any ground whatsoever. It's 1 second too late. Oh! But the reason why I disagree with, desexualizing Dead or Alive 6 is because the argument was, and this is from the developer, and these are his words, not mine, is that it's supposed to... They're trying to emphasize it for esports and saying that these characters are professionals and they are, you know, the best in the world. But the flaw with that argument, and So this is actually why the one thing I actually did want from Nintendo was a wired controller, because half the time when I play this game, there's so many wireless signals flying around in this day and age that I get interference on the Joy-Cons. And so sometimes my controller just wonks out. But the reason why I disagree with the new director's argument of saying it's like, we want to make this more, we want to desexualize it and express that these characters are fighters and such. It's a flawed argument. Because in terms of the story, these characters are the best in the world already. They're already extremely established assassins, ninjas, special ops, drunks. One person actually literally has Drunken Fist as his fighting style. Taekwondo. That's, oh my god, I can't believe I'm forgetting his name. Zach. I mean, was it Dead or Alive 5's actual motto was, I'm a fighter. And the way I think about it is, like, if you're really judging the game just because half of the cast, and they all dress up extremely maturely. Like, these are honestly, aside from the fan costumes and the DLC, it's like, okay, ninjas. Obviously, ninjas don't exist anymore, so you're gonna have to give at least some leeway here into the fiction. And there is fiction. I mean, for God's sakes, was it? The first boss of Dead or Alive was actually a Tengu. A mythical Japanese creature. That was your first big boss in the Dead or Alive franchise. It was an actual Tengu. You know, it's a big, fat male Tengu who absolutely destroyed you. Just like he destroyed me. Good job, Sugar. I mean, the overarching plot of Dead or Alive was you're taking on Doa Tech, this corporate conglomerate. They know how to do... See, these people are doing teamwork. I got greedy! I wanted the 3. Got him. Nah, he's gonna pick that up. Gonna spot you. Gonna spot you! And then... Come on, one more spawn. I got greedy. And then I get greedy. But it's trying to sell itself for esports and trying to say it's like, our characters are serious. Like, your characters are already as serious as can be. They're already as mature as can be. They're adults and they're all fighters fighting in tournaments and stuff, or they're owning corporations and stuff. And there's already very heavy adult themes that Street Fighter wouldn't even dare touch. And so when you have things like that, it's like, well, if you try and change, you're trying to change the image here, but you're going about it the wrong way. I completely miss Sugar. Sugar is apparently my rival here. Which is why honestly, I don't understand what the new director is thinking or the direction he wants to take the series. Because it's... I'm going to lose that fight because I'm going to run out of ammo again. The heck is this person? I'm dead. That's all you control with the masses. truth, and, you know, there will be people who... And there will be people, no doubt in my mind. There will be people who will basically look at Dead or Alive and just use it. Am I having frames drops? I am having frames drops now. There are many frame drops. It says it's stabilizing, though, right now. God, this sub... My sub takes so much ink, it's ridiculous. How's it going, Plenty of Time? How are you doing? But here's the thing, like, even, you know, the majority of people, though, they like... Okay, that has gotta go away now. Oh, whoops. All it takes is that one little bit of ink. One clam. I was one clam off. Have yourself a good night, Balthier. How's my night going? Oh, it's going okay. Apparently right now, though, we're suffering a lot of frame drops because my internet... It is my internet. It's not on your end, I can tell you right now. Is dropping. I'm enjoying the multiplayer for Splatoon. Just because I haven't really gotten to play it. This week has kind of been a busy week for me. There's a lot going on in my personal life right now that I am trying to deal with. We have not scored at all, and that can actually really happen in this game. Yeah, no, I'm sorry. It definitely is fluctuating up and down, so... I apologize for the frame rate drops. I am enjoying Splatoon. I really am. I'm having a lot of fun with it. It's definitely a game... It's, you know, it definitely is a good multiplayer game. I like that you can basically just pick it up, go into a match, and you can play it. What's honestly strange is I haven't increased my... KBPS for OBS, and yet it's really up and down past its normal route. But it's clearly a connection issue. So it could just be someone else is uploading something. It really could be something as simple as that. The only reason why, honestly, Prinny, thank you very much for letting me know. Part of the reason why I haven't been able to notice it is... And this is a change in the dashboard. You know, if I had like a huge 4K monitor, it wouldn't be a problem, but the real problem I'm having right now is that the size of chat in the dashboard, it's massive now. And so when you have a lower viewership, like most affiliates do, or just people who stream as a hobby, the moment it reaches the bottom... Yeah, I had a feeling that was a communication error. The moment it reaches the bottom, it's not going to scroll up as consistently as, say, Proton John's stream or a couple of other people's streams. Could be your ISP is firing fit. Possibly. I honestly think someone's just streaming on this frequency. That's why I'm experiencing a lot of frame drops and such. Because it's spiking. Like, I have OBS set to 2,500. As my upload speed. So that's about half of my total upload speed. That's usually what you should do if you're streaming. But what's happening is that it's spiking up to 3,500 and then sinking down to 500. And that's what's happening. Like my stream health, which I can't even see unless it hits zero. Because once again, they made the thing that they need to do on the Twitch dashboard is they need to make it flexible, adjustable. Not in just simply of where it is, but also in how big it is. So you can resize the actual chat in the dashboard. Here's the thing. I've actually been able to go affiliate for about a year and a half ago. But the reason I didn't take it was, and this is honestly a personal fault, I let the perfect be the enemy of the good. I wanted to, you know, I have a lot of ideas in my head in terms of like, hey, I want to create this, I want to create that. But the hard part is either I lack the resources or the means to do so. And it got to the point where it's like, I need to just do it. I need to just join the, you know, join the program and actually make an honest effort in trying to create a business plan. For the most part, honestly, pretty I was it. You're right. And the reason why was for those reasons. I wanted to actually make a, I wanted to really make it a business. I wanted to have a concrete plan so that when I look at, you know, when I do things like streaming and such, I'm going to be able to just say, it's like, okay, you know, this is, you know, people are know what they're know, they know what they're going to get from, like, watching my stream and what I'm going to do with, you know, with their fun stuff. And I still want to do that, and that's what I'm still going to do. Damn it. So I still have that as part of, you know, in terms of building it, but it really just came down to, like, instead of it being an actual business, like an, like a sole proprietorship, it's like, just join it right now and slowly work on everything else. Because one of the big things I was constantly slowing myself down on was I was trying to get take care of everything. I was trying to make it, like, the perfect stream when I shouldn't be doing that. Wow, I walked in that one. You've got me anything? Well, honestly, like I said, nothing in terms of, primarily in terms of content, nothing, not much is actually going to change. It doesn't really need to change, because most of my, the big thing is like just making sure I could actually stream consistently, and making this my, you know, my primary time to play video games. Like, that's honestly one of the big things. Is making this my time to actually, you know, play video games and have conversations with people. Because honestly, I'm more interested in just actually hearing how other people are doing than just simply talking about myself or, you know, my own personal ego. That's not how I approach things. Like, I actually like, you know, when, you know, people ask, like, you know, what am I drawing about E3? And I could just rant very much like Total Biscuit about things like Dead or Alive or other, you know, or other things that, you know, I enjoy as my hobby and such. Because I can just go on for that for hours. Alright, I can't grab that because it's a football. Oh, hello. Oh, I need a clam. And I lost it. I mean, I just hope people can just, you know, watch and be entertained and enjoy themselves. And I always, like, I'll say this right now, like, the scoreboard for this game is honestly kind of confusing. Wow, Abe is just wrecking face with that end zap. But like I said, I can just go on for hours about Dead or Alive 6, how I think it's the wrong direction, I think the person who's now in charge of the franchise, their vision, they're chasing a pipe dream. You don't build a game for esports. Thank you. Finally actually got A because I had the range advantage. And good job, Funko Man. Now he has a, I didn't even know they had a squelcher gun that actually had the that had the splat bomb as an option. I still like the sensor more. And I know it's not the best time to, Nope! One downside. I wish this was something they could actually fix is... with the dualies, and this isn't a bug, this is a personal preference thing. The moment... I just need to hunt down the person with the football. And they're gonna get it. Have you tried any of the umbrella weapons? Not really. Honestly, I see that they're good weapons. Now that I understand, like, you just have to hold out the fire button to get the shield, to launch from your umbrella. Because that was the one thing I never understood. About the umbrella weapons, or the umbrella weapons. I never understood that part about it until I played through the single player game. Like, right now, I really like the guns I'm using now. Because they're still fast enough in terms of fire range. They may be low damage, but the fire rate compensates for that. But the most important thing, and this is a personal preference, is range. I was okay with the Splattershot Jr. and the NZAP. But those, you know, they're two basically, was it, the NZAPs are Splattershot Jr. But, I like the range right now. Because I'm in that spot where it's like, I know I'm not good enough yet, I still need to practice on, like, the aim and stuff. Because the sensitivity, you could make the sensitivity in this game absurdly quick. And I'm not the type of... I tried the motion controls. I was terrible with the motion controls. I was absolutely atrocious with the motion controls. And I'm not even at the point where it's like I'm earning enough gear to actually... I was hoping they would actually just rush for it. No, I can see that, but I'm... Like I said, I think that's definitely gonna be for the younger generation, who's actually... can acclimate towards that really, really well. I am not one of those people. I am an old man. I am set in my ways of playing games in a very analog fashion instead of a, instead of being wireless or using motion controls and such. I have no problem admitting that. That will take... Really? No, I wasn't... Alright. I will take that. Take care of two of them. No! Ah, I missed. Go for the rebound! Yeah, so... It's same thing with, was it? Mario Tennis Aces. Same thing. There's motion controls. They're super awesome. They're very efficient. But I am terrible with them. And I have no problem admitting that. There are things I'm good at, and there are things I am not. And I'm very old and set in my ways. And I will admit... Wow, this is a mess! Oh, my barrier's back up. But I'm out of the mindset. If it works for you, awesome. If it doesn't... No! Don't hamster ball me! I don't know how I lived. Ew. Was there a third? No! Ah, there's someone else there. But I like having, doing the rants and stuff, like, because I am a person who likes rants, but at the same time, I'm no, part of me is a know-it-all. The other part of me knows, I'm not going to act like a know-it-all. I'm going to, you know, do my best to make desertions. I have knowing. Okay. That's my weakness in this game. I always run out of ink too soon. And that's a personal issue. But I'm Tish. Oh, I have no ink! So throwing out the sensor destroys, at least for this, and I don't have the gear for it. Like, that's the other level about it that makes this game really unique, is the customization options that exist. Yeah, clean all that up. Clean all that up. Fire. How did... Okay, good. For a second, I thought I didn't kill all of them. And also, I'm just realizing we're down a person's AFK. That's really unfortunate. Now that I made that realization... How did... Ah, darn it, the slosher. Oh, please, don't have a football. Good. At least that person who's AFK is gonna get a nice surprise. Let's see, did he actually play? Yeah, oh yeah, he played. He just walked away from his controller. That's fine. Like, there's a lot of games I want to get, but I know it's just not within my budget. So it's like, I can't really afford them. But it's like, that's the reason why I did the whole beat the backlog stuff. I wanted to see if it was sustainable, if I could stream it, if it was something that can be done, and see if it looks like it can. And I'm still gonna primarily focus on that. I know it's not what people really want to watch on Twitch. Like, if I can nail down what people want to watch on Twitch right now, it's really very simple and fundamental. They want IRL with text-to-speech, so they literally want people who are Ice Poseidon. They want ASMR, primarily from, you know, they want women just to stand in front of a camera and look pretty. It's really, like, honestly, it's one of the things I just realized, like, it's the perfect statement. We've G-rated pornography in this day and age. That is what we have done with streaming. That's how far it has come. And you can, and like, that'll easily be probably one of the most controversial things I'll ever say on stream. I need actually. So the one thing that actually makes me terrible at this game mode is that I never look at the map. I never look at the minimap. And see, it's like, oh, what I need to actually do. I never look at it. That is why I am terrible at it. There we go. I also just learned you could also throw your clams at any time. Just give them to a player. Terrible at this game. I have moments of brilliance and then moments of just being terrible. Also, that's why I stay in the back primarily. Oh, they are destroyed. They just destroyed us. Are we down a player, or are we actually literally down a player? I actually can't tell if we're down a player or not. Yeah, we're down a player. Oh, no, we're not down a player. This person knows how to play a little too well. Oh, I see. The barrier stays down as long as you're throwing clams inside of it. Oh, that makes a lot of sense, actually. And there you go. That is how you do a quick knock. That is how you do a knockout. That was impressive. I really hope one person was actually AFK, but I don't think it was. Nope, we were all okay. We just did terrible. We just did horrible. But that's fine. Like I said, I like Splatoon 2. It's a solid game. I honestly am interested in Senran Kagura Peach Beach Splash. And maybe if I get the resources. The reason I actually bought this was actually on sale. And there's actually a sale right now. Nintendo is doing an E3 sale. And I think this is down to... And it'll be digital download, because obviously you're buying from Nintendo. It's down to $40, actually. And it's actually that's actually about how much I paid for this. It was, you know, huge... This, like I said, there'll always be a huge difference between paying $60 for something, paying $50 for something, and paying $40 for something. You know? And I think that's an important... Something important when it comes to, like, the price of games and the cost. Because, you know, one person's 10, might as well just be another person's 100. Damn. I actually split up. Oh, so you can actually dash over to that. I didn't know that. This is where I am terrible at this game. Oh. That Alan person has good anticipation skills. But like I said, personally, on a personal level, I didn't have many games I saw as like, oh, I've got to play this, or I've got to buy this from E3. I saw a lot of them as games that... Oh, we are just gonna get our score handed to us. Yep, that's... Oh, they did an excellent job. How do you only get two of them? Oh, pick it up! Make the rebound! The rebound! That was a lot, but unfortunately, compared to them throwing an onslaught of clams, it's not enough. The little purple dots there are actually clams we can pick up and actually use. I get a football, that's too late. Now I'm just trying to build up a special. are not good at shooting, buddy. I feel bad for him. So dead. So close, but their deaths are so staggered. I wasn't able to get the throw it in. Sorry, I had to really focus there on that one. That was really good though. Like if it was any other game, that was really good, but. Unfortunately. Unfortunately, they won it. We had one good moment. We had one really good moment. 15! My goodness, that's actually the highest I think I've ever gotten. But it's like I haven't gotten to the point where it's like I'm specializing my abilities and sub-abilities or stats and stuff. I think this might be the last match for the night. But like I said, slow changes in the stream in terms of visual appearance, production stuff is going to be very slow. And I emphasize the word very slow. But I'm not going to let the enemy be the perfect be the enemy of the good. So I'm gonna slowly try and roll things out. Just try and still, because in reality, I still need to focus on my real life over anything else. And I know, like, because primarily it's like I still want to do streaming, but I know streaming won't be the main thing that'll actually gain a viewership. If that makes sense, because there's very few people who actually succeed at making streaming a career just from streaming. You have to produce additional forms of content in this day and age. And I acknowledge that completely. And that's the reason why it's like I've never actually really just jumped on the affiliate, because I wanted, like, everything to go at once. And that's the reason why it's like it probably hasn't, just simply because it's all too easy just to let everything. Hey, thank you, clams. Have some missiles! Too late! We broke it! I don't think anyone else is gonna be able to monopolize on that, but that's fine. Like, this is actually, to me, like, the perfect sort of, meta. Because it still has a focus, but I don't have to take it super serious.
Darn, I got it.
They had a lot, actually. How many clams do they have? I know the monopolize off of it. No, I lost that one easy. Someone better get that football. I'm actually surprised, they actually didn't know this game mode actually would just simply spawn footballs the moment barriers are broken. But they actually do give... Yeah, see, we broke their barrier. They do give players the means to actually succeed. Damn it. Hunted me down like a dog. And, Nifty, you need to hit it with the ink. You can get out of there, buddy. I believe in you. Bollocks, I'm out of ammo! Oh, there was... I thought that was... No, there was only one. I still died to the one person. Oh, we just barely took it. Like I said, this is actually a very nice game, actually. This is a good multiplayer game to get interested in. At least, you know, because one of the most important things, and I think that's honestly one of the downsides for a lot of multiplayer games now, that makes it suffer, was the fact that... I see you. Is that there's so many multiplayer games out there. There's way too many nowadays. I don't even know how that works. Broke the barrier. And why can't I throw any further? Oh well. Oh. That's not good. Lost. Or no, maybe not. Oh, we did lose. Never mind. I guess they did pull it out at the end. There we go. That's about. Like I said, you really do have to dedicate a lot of playtime to this game if you want to collect everything. Or at least buy everything. But I think that's gonna do it for me tonight. I had a lot of fun playing this game. It's a solid game, honestly. Octolings shall inherit the earth. Evil, evil Octolings. How could you? Hello, world! Hello. I think I'm gonna stick being a squid than an octoling. Then again, I don't know what what the hairstyles are. Aside from this fro. That is one. That is a fro. But that's gonna do it for me. Like I said, I'm glad to be part. I'm glad I finally actually just decided to join the affiliate program, and I'm slowly gonna work things, slowly change things. Add alerts. Take away alerts, change alerts, commission some artists, get like icons and everything, because I have a theme I want to follow through, but the hard part is basically finding the people that can actually do it. That's actually been honestly one of my biggest struggles, is I just haven't been able to find
artists that can actually do like mech and tech. And not like the steampunk, I'm talking like Armored Core art aesthetics. I've talked to a lot of artists over the year and a half that I was an affiliate, and I haven't found a single one. Everyone is very niche on their art style. But that's gonna do it for me tonight. Let me take a look and see who else is streaming right now here. And hopefully he's actually still going, because I think Cthulhu the Third streaming. He is an awesome... He is actually currently playing Super Ghosts and Goblins. If you know that game, it is an incredibly brutal game. But Cthulhu the Third is a really, really great retro streamer. He's hails back all the way from the Justin TV days. And is a great streamer to watch and support. But that's going to do it for me tonight. Tomorrow, I don't know what I really have planned. Like I said, this month is really going to be very intermittent. Really focused on trying to take care of things in my real life. And it's almost through. Almost through until I can get back to a steadier schedule of streaming and such, where I'll have more planned content of like games I want to beat, games I want to stream, and just games to do things for multiplayer. And I'll start, and it's now that I'm an affiliate, it's a good time to start sitting and planning, and so I can actually just talk straight to you guys, straight to people who want to watch the stream, to know if they sub to me, they're not just giving some random stranger on the internet money. You know, I want to tell them, it's like, this is what your money's going towards, this is what you're supporting, this is what you'll be getting in return if you support my stream. And that's what I want to do. But until then, though, go check out Cthulhu the Third. He is a great retro streamer. And as always, though, until then, take care.